but my heart lies waiting over the phone. I still call Australia home.
When I was a kid, I honestly thought this song was written for me, because I knew one day I'd leave. But now I'm back, and I can tell you, when I was out there, I always found my way home via the music made by today's master. His songs read like love letters and felt like safe harbours in the sky for the terminally unanchored like me. How does one pay tribute to a musical genius who gave a flash mob of Aussies a sense of identity and cultural belonging? I don't know if I'm up to the task, but I'll certainly give it a good Aussie go. In today's Masters episode, we're having coffee with Peter Allen.
I still call Australia.
Hi everyone, welcome back to Vedic Life Coaching. Thank you so much for joining me, and welcome back to the Masters series. Today we're having coffee with Peter Allen. I'm so excited to do this episode. I didn't know I was going to be doing this episode. I think a week or two ago, his music just started to fill my mind. So I thought, okay, we're doing Peter Allen. That's who it is today. So I started writing the script. As usual, I've done my two-page script thereabouts here on the iPad, so I'm just going to read that out. But before I do, I thought I should explain to my international audience who Peter Allen is, because some of you might be wondering, who is this Peter Allen? Well, the closest analogy I could find was to say that he is like Australia's Michael Jackson. There we go. Why do I say that? I say that because he's a singer-songwriter, he is a great performer, great dancer, and what else did he do that was kind of like Michael Jackson? I think it's just that. I mean, it is that kind of thing where you think, okay, are you coming up with the best music because you love to dance, or are you dancing because you love the music? Like, which, you know, when someone's writing their own music that they dance to, you kind of wonder, don't you? Like, which one comes first? It's really interesting. But, you know, I really wanted to pay tribute to this guy because he made so much beautiful music that lines the memories of my childhood. I grew up listening to the songs made by Peter Allen. His songs were on the TV all the time. They were on ads. He was really popular. He did all these live performances. He was very much in demand. And he lived in New York City. He ended up moving there, I think, and he had this amazing place in New York, some kind of really fancy apartment. I saw it on one of the documentaries that I watched in the research for this episode. It's this gorgeous apartment, I guess, in Manhattan. Uptown, downtown, I don't know, whichever is the posh part, that's where he was. And it's so interesting because when he was flying into JFK Airport one time, he circled above the airport for quite a bit, and he came up with this brilliant line that ended up going into a song that later won him an Oscar. So isn't that just incredible that he writes one line and he wins an Oscar award? I just think that's so amazing. That's even possible. But there you go. That's one of the amazing things that he did. He won a lot of awards. He produced all kinds of beautiful work. The other thing was that he wrote a lot of amazing songs for other people as well. So I believe Olivia Newton-John is one of the artists that he wrote for, amongst many others. So he wrote a lot of great music. But why don't we get into this episode? Oh, by the way, at the beginning of this episode, I think I'm going to edit together like bits of me traveling, because that will match the song that I'm going to choose for the intro, which is I Still Call Australia Home. I just love that song. And so I'm going to dig through old home movies that I made, mostly for my mum, actually. I just made them for her to see where I was going. So you'll see that I'm not wearing any makeup and I probably look like a mess, but I was just making these videos to share with my family. And I think I'm gonna comp together some of that footage at the beginning. So I personally haven't been traveling anywhere for the past year. I don't think I haven't even been on a bus for like a whole year or a train. So that's pretty amazing. and unusual, let me tell you. I'm not happy about that. That's another story though. Why don't we get into the life of Peter Allen? And yeah, let's just see what this script has in store for us. Okay, so working with Peter Allen's charts has been both an immense joy and a mystery. You see, the only thing I'm missing is his time of birth. So I decided to research his biography and see if I could match up key events or themes, in the hope that I could rectify the time to a place where the charts would reflect the man and the life. As I clicked through the hours with the few bits of biographical info I had in mind, I looked for you, Peter, through the many hours that make up the day of your birth. And when I arrived at 10 a.m., I thought I saw you in the outer reaches of the Vargas, out in the D60 chart. In this chart lives a writer. Mercury and Sun ruled by the Moon. So I'm really looking at Mercury and Moon there. In the most creative part of any chart, the fifth house. While doing research about Peter Allen's life, I was struck by the fact that Peter himself didn't know he could write songs. He said, and I quote, "The only time I ever really had an earth-shaking moment was when I realized I could write songs. And that's the day I decided to become a songwriter. And that's the day I broke up my marriage with Liza Minnelli. And I broke up my partnership with the act I had, and it all happened in one day. And I had a whole new life and a whole new career in one night." Isn't that amazing? We've got one day, one night, the whole thing transformed. The word one is very important here. You're going to see why. Anyway, I couldn't find this exact day and night that he talked about in my research, but I did discover that he had left Liza Minnelli and his double act partner sometime in 1970. Amazingly, Saturn is transiting through Aries, while Jupiter transits the opposite house of Libra for that entire year, making it a ripe year for major overhauls in partnerships, both marriage and business. In the 10 a.m. chart, this is happening second and eighth from his ascendant. So the themes of family change, dependence, independence, career transformation, and other people's resources were all in focus. Saturn quite possibly pressing all the weak links in Aries and asking Peter, "Come on, mate, why can't you do all this on your own? You're ready now." All the while, Sun Rahu and Sun Jupiter were active, bringing a stack of accumulated good karma to the fore through his natal Ketu and encouraging him to shine through both Rahu and Jupiter. Let's not forget that all that goodness was also being expressed through the Sun in the fifth house of the D60. It makes sense that his Sun Dasha was active during 1970. Another thing that I like about the 10 a.m. rectification is that it brings Peter's Rahu Ketu axis in line with the Rahu Ketu axis in his ex-wife's spouse chart, in Liza Minnelli's D9 chart. Thankfully, we have her time to the precise minute, 7:58 in the morning. And so I trust the information presented in all of her charts. Interestingly, in Peter Allen's D1 chart, Venus is on the world stage in the 10th house. A short and sweet astrological description of Liza Minnelli, if ever there was one, who seemed like she was born to live on stage. Another description of Liza is by Peter himself, in perhaps the greatest Australian song ever written, Tenterfield Sadler, where he talks about marrying the girl with an interesting face. In this moving, gentle, and lyrical work of art, Peter takes us through his past, which features a string of heartbreaking hardships, war, addiction, poverty, and the shocking suicide of his own father. In the space of a song, Peter heals his entire male ancestral line and frees himself from a tough heritage that would be enough to trap anyone into a lifetime of suffering. Instead of letting the narrative of his life own him, through one song, he owns it. Astrologically, we can see Peter's sun conjunct Ketu, sun representing the father, and Ketu representing the past, our past lives, sometimes past karma, past gifts. There's a lot in there. Through contemplating this line in Peter's chart, an important thing occurred to me, that when you have Ketu up there in Saturn and Rahu ruled by the moon, a person really has mastered thought energy and is ready, if not required, to develop mastery in the realm of feeling, of what it is to feel. And as I learnt from David Hawkins, thousands of thoughts equals one feeling. And this is what Peter's legacy demonstrates above all else. One song so full of feeling, emerging from those dreamy Cancerian waters, can somehow magically wash away whatever Saturnian blues were clocked up over the generations. Rahu Jupiter in that fifth house in Cancer says a lot about the quality of Peter's performances. Firstly, the lord of this house, the moon, is very full, being almost opposite the sun. Through watching Peter perform, I discovered that a good moon like his wants to give. They say that the first rule of show business is to always leave them wanting more. I'm sure audiences would have been shouting encore when Peter would finish, but I can imagine they'd leave fully nourished whether he came back or not. Every aspect of his being was giving. His sunburnt smile, his innocent Jupiterian expression, and the honesty embedded in the chipped timber of his voice. I've never known a performer to be so giving. It's as if he's saying, "You want my heart? Here, take it. You want the kitchen sink? Take that too. Is that $1 million? Must be for you. I give it all because I know that one day I'll be gone, and so will you." Astrology aside, I have long wondered, how were his songs so thick with nostalgia? I wonder this because his time here was so fleeting, and it feels like somehow he knew that 48 years on this earth would be all that he'd get. It's as if his feet never really touched the ground, as though he was suspended between the earth and the stars, so able to accurately reminisce over what every aspect of human life would be like. Peter's songs didn't just provide an identity to a nation. As we saw through Tenterfield Sadler, he healed an entire ancestral line. Through Go to Rio, he helped everyone release life stuck in tight places. And through Oscar-winning Arthur's Theme, he told us all what to do if we get caught between the moon and New York City. I'm so lucky I grew up in a place and a time where these are the songs that line the memories of my childhood and that remind me that no matter how far I go, home is only ever one song away. All this brings me to my final point, which will help solve the small mystery I raised just moments ago and includes vital information for all students of astrology. What exactly do you do if you get caught between the moon and New York City? Well, as Peter so charmingly instructs, the best that you can do is fall in love. So that's my brief take on the life of Peter Allen. Wasn't easy to do as I didn't have his time. If you know his time and you're able to, please do put it in the comments below. But otherwise, you're very welcome to comment on anything astrological that I've mentioned. If you've spotted something else astrological in his chart, you're very welcome to put that in the comments below. You can also tell me, what were the songs that line the memories of your childhood? I would love to know. what kind of music you enjoyed when you were a kid. It's always fun to go down memory lane, isn't it? And take a look at that. You know, I don't know what song I'm going to have playing in the background for the outro now, but I think, and I might put a bit of footage. Yeah, we're okay for time. I might put a bit of footage of Peter performing so that you can see. And I feel like I want, the one that I want, I think, is either, I should probably put the one with the moon in New York City. It might be that one, or it might be another one where he's singing Once Before I Go. It's a beautiful song. So it's going to be very difficult for me to choose the music to go out because there are so many songs I love. Very difficult to choose. So who knows, I will choose something when I'm editing and possibly give you a bit of Peter performing so you can see just that giving nature of his. He really does give a lot when he's performing. So thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you next time.
Hold me close once more, just once before I go. I want you to know that I have loved you all along. Though we might be miles apart, I only need to feel your living in my heart, and I'll be strong. You are the light that shines on me. You always were and you'll always be. And I had to let you know just this once before I go. And it's so hard to say goodbyes when there's so much that's left unspoken in your eyes. But unless I spread my wings again, I'm afraid I never saw. So kiss me, fatherland.